Okay, good evening to everybody. Now let us discuss about colloidals after coagulation. Coagulation or precipitation or flocculation. Okay, first of all, the stability of the lyophobic salts is due to the presence of charge on the colloidal particles. That means due to the presence of charge, lyophobic salts are stable. If this charge is neutralized, the particles will come nearer to each other to form aggregates or coagulate and settle down under the force of gravity. That means if the charge on the lyophobic salts is neutralized, therefore the particles will come nearer to each other to form aggregates or coagulates and settle down under the force of gravity. Therefore, this process of settling down of colloidal particles, this process of settling down of colloidal particles is known as coagulation or precipitation or flocculation of the salt. That means the coagulation of lyophobic salts can be carried out with the following ways. That means coagulation of lyophobic salts can be done by the following methods. First method is electrophoresis method. Second method is by mixing two oppositely charged salts. Third method is by prolonged dialysis. Fourth method is by addition of electrolytes. These methods are used for the coagulation of lyophobic salts. First method is electrophoresis. Electrophoresis means the colloidal particles move towards oppositely charged electrodes. Therefore, these oppositely charged electrodes, colloidal particles get discharged and finally precipitated. That means the colloidal particles move towards the oppositely charged electrodes. Therefore, immediately colloidal particles get discharged and precipitated. This is the electrophoresis technique used for the precipitation of the lyophobic salts. Second method is by mixing two oppositely charged salts. When oppositely charged salts when mixed in equal proportions, in equal quantities, therefore the charge of colloidal particles, are mutually neutralized and get precipitated. For example, hydrated ferric oxide salt, it is a positively charged salt, and arrhenius sulfide salt, it is a negatively charged salt. Both are mixed with equal proportions, therefore both salts are neutralized, therefore they bring them in the precipitated form. This type of coagulation is known as mutual coagulation. Another method is used by boiling method. By boiling, when a salt is boiled, therefore the adsorbed layer is disturbed due to the increased number of collisions with the molecules of the dispersion medium. Therefore, this reduces the charge on the colloidal particles and they ultimately settle down in the form of precipitate. Therefore, boiling method is also used for the precipitation of lyophobic salts. Next fourth method is by prolonged dialysis. On prolonged dialysis, traces of the electrolytes present in the salts are removed completely and the colloids become unstable and ultimately coagulated. That means on prolonged dialysis, traces quantity of electrolyte present in the colloidal solution rapidly decreases and finally electrolytes are removed from the colloidal solution completely. Therefore, the colloids become unstable and ultimately leading to coagulation. This is the another method for coagulation of lyophobic colloids. Next, fifth method is by addition of electrolytes, by addition of electrolytes. When excess of an electrolyte, when excess of an electrolyte is added, the colloidal particles are precipitated. The ion responsible for the neutralization of charge on the particles, that is called coagulating ion. Coagulating ion or percolating ion. That means a negatively charged electrolyte ion coagulate positively charged salt and vice versa. That means the coagulation power of coagulating ion was determined by Hardy-Schulz rule. That means, for example, a negatively charged ion, when added to a positively charged salt, it causes coagulation. The negatively charged ion is called coagulating ion or percolative ion, as it neutralizes the colloid to cause coagulation. Example, coagulation of lyophilic salts. That means Hardy-Schulz rule. According to Hardy-Schulz rule, the greater the valence of the percolating ion added, the greater is its precipitation. Hardy-Schulz rule tells that greater the valency of the coagulating ion added, the greater is its coagulating power. That means for negative salts, when positively ions are added, that means cations are added, the coagulating power of cations increases in the order. Al3 plus is greater than Ba2 plus is greater than Na plus. That means Al3 plus having greater coagulating power compared to Na plus ion. If positively salts, when negative ions, that means anions are added, therefore the coagulating power of coagulating ions is in the order FeCN6-4- is greater than PO4-3- is greater than SO4-2- sulfate ion is greater than chloride ion. That means FeCN6-4- is more powerful coagulating power compared to chloride ion. FeCN6-4- is greater than phosphate ion. PO4-3- is greater than sulfate ion. SO4-2- is greater than Cl-. That means according to Hardy-Schulz rule, greater the valency of the coagulating ion added, the greater is its power to cause coagulation. That is known as Hardy-Schulz rule. For negatively charged salts, positively charged ions are added for coagulation. That means cations are used for coagulation. Valence increases, coagulation power also increases. Therefore, valency of the coagulating ion is directly proportional to the coagulating power of the colloidal solution. This tells about Hardy-Schulz rule. Okay, thank you.